cinema is a sense, in Indian cinema, the sense of songs and music is dancing. This session talks about choreography and dance direction in films. Therefore, today, we have with us everyone's favorite Bollywood filmmaker choreographer, who has choreographed iconic songs like Pehla Nasha, Chhaiya Chhaiya, to party songs like It's the Time to Disco. She is an exceptional speaker and storyteller. She has achieved international recognition and was nominated for the Tony Award as Best Choreographer. She is a role model for many aspiring choreographers and directors. Please put your hands together for the National Award winning choreographer, Ms. Farah Khan. To take this session forward, we have a well-known film critic. He reviews Bollywood films and major Hollywood films released in India in his weekend show, Now Showing. Please welcome our moderator for this session, Mr. Rajiv Masand. Now I would request Mr. Rahul Rave and Mr. Chaitanya Prasad.
Many hats.
Very good afternoon, everybody. Sorry, Rajiv.
They're tired of me. So.
How are you all? Let's have some fun now. Huh? Let's not be boring.
Well, you wear so many hats. You started, of course, as choreographer, but you're a filmmaker, you're a writer, you're a producer, you're...
One-time actress.
Actress. If you don't count all the cameos.
Cameos are not...
You're also now, I mean, talk show host, game show host, judge. What is, in your head, who you are? What do you think of yourself as far? I know that you started as choreographer, but that was sort of accidental, right? It was filmmaking that was always...
Yes. So in my head, I think I'm mother to my three children.
Right.
That's the primary role that... So everything revolves around them. Now, after this session, I have to rush back, take a flight and go back home.
Right.
Because they're three alone at home. But I think most importantly, though I've done the least of that,
correct,
is filmmaking. Like,
right,
I've literally directed just four movies in almost 12 years.
And you know, it's interesting to say that, but because that is true in terms of the names, the number of films that you have your name on as director. But it's also true actually that a lot of your choreography isn't just dance direction. You know, the choreography used to be dance direction. It was about directing steps and. You were telling stories with your songs right from the start, weren't
that
you?
That is true. Thank you so much. So I went for a short film panel discussion,
right,
and they asked me whether I would ever make a short film. Well, my shortest film was 2 hours, 57 minutes long. But other than that, I think every song of mine is almost a short film because it always has a beginning, it has a middle, it has an end, it has a little story, it has humor, it has dance, probably doesn't have action in it. But barring that, there is a lot being said. So I like to treat every song as a short story that you have to tell in 5 minutes and be entertaining and have the, of course, your song and dance and the hook step and everything.
You know, one of my favorites where you really told the story entirely, the song was, and you probably kept the best one for your husband, was in Jaaneman.
Yeah.
Tumko Maloom Hai.
Actually, yeah, Jaaneman has a lot of songs which. But that I also have to credit to the director, because sometimes the directors don't really have a story to the song. They will say, college ka gaana hai. And the hero is 40 years old, dancing in college. And or they'll say, shaadi ka gaana hai. Or they'll just say, item gaana hai, abhi aap kuch bhi karo. So those are the most difficult. The easier ones are where the director has a clear vision of what his song is going to do, how it's going to take the song forward. So yeah, in Jaaneman.
How clear are the directors with that vision? Now, you're not known to mince words, so let today not be that occasion when you're mincing words. You're saying the best ones are the ones where the director have great clarity. Now, really, how
the, much... The best ones are the ones that have great clarity because they really help, like Mani Ratnam.
Right.
He has great clarity of how the song should be, and he always pushes the technicians to not do the usual stuff.
Right.
The other kind of director who's good is who doesn't have clarity but doesn't want to interfere.
Right. So but there is a third kind as well, isn't it?
Yeah. The third is who doesn't have clarity and wants to interfere. Doesn't have clarity but has a big ego.
Right.
So both are the worst ones. Because I'm like, yaar, tu kar le ya mujhe karne de. So But the, if a director knows what he wants, it really helps.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know how many of you are film students or wanting to be actors or wanting to be directors. Yes. So I think if a director says, kuch bhi kar le, it's, unless you're like genius, like I am, but or a director will tell you exactly what guide you help you to get your creativity out and say this.
The best ideas.
So I think those, luckily I've worked with quite a few of them. Kundan Shah being one. On Kaviya Kavina. Mansoor being one on Jojita Voy Sikandar. Mani sir. So all my best work, Shirish was like that. He was very clear.
Right.
Maybe not on the rest of the movie, but in the songs. He was very clear how the song has to go, which is why it was written in a certain way.
When you eventually made your first film, which is really such a lovely film, it's so much fun and it really turns the whole campus film on its head. And you did sort of many things with it. You've also been an unapologetic fan of the big commercial masala movie.
Yes.
And Mehuna was a great example of how you can do that. And it doesn't need to be dumb, because I think I know the critics are guilty of that. I think a lot of us are guilty of the fact that when you talk about commercial films, you kind of associate it with being silly or.
I didn't say leave your brain behind at home. No, please don't leave any body part behind at home when you go to watch a movie.
Right.
You should take all your parts with you. Yes, but I think the general perception is that if a film is commercial and if a film is entertaining, it can't be of any value.
Right.
You know, a film of value is one which is very boring and where you're thinking, oh my god, and especially you can't understand it even better, because then go out and say, what a piece of art, wow. So unfortunately, we all are prejudiced.
But do you have an appreciation for some of those films?
Of course, Rajiv, I love all sort of movies. A lot of movies I watch and I just love them for the terror, the serenity, because I don't have that in my movies. My movies are always in a flurry and they are energetic and I'm eager to please and not wanting people to get bored. But the movies that let you actually breathe, and I admire those movies. The only thing a movie should not do is bore me.
Sure.
You know, a movie can engage me on different levels. It can, it should actually make you feel some sort of emotion, either the laughter or crying or pathos or comedy or something, but without boring you or make you think. You know, I don't expect a film to educate me, because I went to school.
Great.
So I'm buying a ticket privately.
Or at least not educate you in that obvious
manner.
Obvious,
preachy manner.
If it's a
Munawai, it's lovely, because it's funny and it's so tongue-in-cheek and it's still telling you something.
Right.
You know, at the end of it. But that's not the primary object, I feel, of a film.
Right.
The pressure is being put now, okay, bolo, social message, do.
Right.
You know, if society had to be turned around by movies, then Gandhigiri would be the new religion, which it clearly is not, and India-Pakistan peace treaty would have happened post-Mehuna.
Yeah,
but clearly, so don't blame all bad things on movies also.
But you've also been very vocal and very clear that you don't want to be, you don't want to be seen, or certainly you don't want to be described as the woman director. You know, the woman director who makes commercial films. At the cost of being unpopular, that's a crutch that a lot of your peers,
But as you know, I don't like crutches.
Right. Why is that?
Genuinely don't think a director needs to have a gender. It's not a gender specific job. It's not a being an actress or an actor that we can only do female roles, or a man can only do male roles, and why not sometimes they do both also.
Right.
So that's something that I always rejected right as a beginning. They would say, aapki photo, we want to do a photo shoot with female directors, and I was like, no, you want to do a photo shoot with directors, I'll come and stand there, but don't slot me in that. And very strangely, I find a lot of women directors accepting, not only accepting that, but but reveling in that, which I don't think is, and then you talk of gender parity and pay parity and all, which will never happen if you gender divide these roles. I'm a director, sometimes I get, I mean, I just happen to be a woman,
right,
which makes me more organized, more hardworking, and better at my job. But other than that, if you remove my name from Mehuna and you put,
yeah, you can't tell.
You put Farhan Khan, how will you know whether a man or a woman directed it?
Right.
Would you? You would not.
But do, you know, in the way that actresses speak of having it harder than men, and it's not related to, I mean, it's related to things like, you know, vanity, it's related to things like what the expectation is, and I don't even know if it's the audience expectation as much as it is the industry expectation, that you have to be in your 20s if you're going to be a romantic hero. I mean, the actresses have it harder. You know, the shelf life of an actress is shorter than the actor's life. Is that true of the woman who directs? Did you find yourself being treated differently?
No, in fact, I started directing very late. Actually, I should have directed earlier, which is why I feel a technician doesn't have an age,
right,
a shelf life, or an, you know, obviously actresses only, because once you're 40 or whatever, you're not going to get a 20 ka, you should not also do a teenage girl in love. Or you have to do
age. You though became a hero and you played your first leading role if you're 40, huh?
Yes, but that was a 40-year-old
that's
woman,
right,
who was
that's
not
right
finding anyone to marry her. So that's the only reason I did that, because it was very much age appropriate and could have been my life. If I had waited a little longer.
No, no,
so, no, I think I would say if the actresses feel that they are not being paid accordingly or that they have it harder, it's only because it's a business module. Big heroes, big ticket movies with big heroes tend to get more business. And so I blame the audience for that, because
right,
they want to go and watch that movie over a female-centric movie. The minute that changes, a female-centric movie goes past the 100.
But why doesn't anyone make? I mean, why hasn't there been the big-budget movie with a woman at the center of it?
Because I think till that first one doesn't happen, everyone is. So see, abroad also they do make. I mean, they make a Wonder Woman, but then they make a Ocean's 8, bombs, and they make a Ghostbusters with a female star cast, it bombs. So. But they are making that video now.
Right.
They are making, so but the big budget, but then.
Right. So it's ultimately about the performance of the film.
It's a business module, I think. I don't know how many of you all agree with that, but the audience wants to go see the big heroes movie over a female centric movie. So next time there's a female centric movie, go to the theater and watch it. Don't wait to watch it on Netflix and Amazon and Hotstar. Pay money, watch it, make it a big hit so that the cycle breaks.
I know that you've spoken about how you don't want to be saddled with the responsibility to have to make a woman-centric film. I know you said that, but what is the responsibility that you do feel as a woman who's wielding the mic on a film set?
See, I feel no director should be told what they want to or don't want to make.
Sure.
That pressure should not be put on anybody.
Sure.
Everybody needs to make the movie that comes from within you and that you are comfortable making. It will be exactly like someone making a woman-centric movie. Why are you making this? Don't make this, you make that.
Right.
So that pressure should not be put on anyone. I think in all my movies, I just make sure that the woman has a job. She's not just there for the romantic. Even Sushmita was a teacher. However, you commercialized it and you made it glamorous and all, but it was not just one. They are not only there because they want to get married to somebody. And I see that in a lot of, you say, oh, he's a woman-centric maker and all, but all the women want to do in those movies is run away to get married. So that's all their ambition is, that mujhe shaadi karni hai. That you'll never see, because I don't think that's what women should wake up and feel first thing. And you will not see me doing any obscenity, or there won't be any vulgarity in the film. There'll be song and dance, and they will look glamorous, like I said. They will look sexy also. But